those implants, but it's like $3,000 a tooth.
Yeah.
It is. It's expensive. And the other one is MATC. They're hygienists, so they clean your teeth for like $40, and this is a one-time fee you pay. And they're looking for clients. They do deep cleaning and more detailed than your own doctor's office will do. And they need patients and children there at MATC. But Marquette is a great place. I just joined them this year, and they got plenty of people that are still looking for it. He said, if you know anybody, let them know. And then you have to ask them about the insurance. We have insurance. They really don't send your insurance in, but they set up a plan where how you can send them into your insurance that'll reimburse you. But if you're on Medicare or Medicaid, I believe they take that insurance, and it's pretty much almost like free. So get into knowing about them. Y'all call on the phone. And I'm telling you, Marquette is a great place to go. I was there many years ago when I was younger, and I just happened to switch back because the services that we have at my job, we have good insurance, but the place I go to, several of them, they're so expensive for a crown or a bridge, it'll take all your money out of your account that you have to get your work done for one thing, you know.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
There's certain training. I believe there's two. I inquired, and because I've seen a gentleman, and I believe it's two black young men who are going to be dentists that are there, and you can't request any specific person or anything, and I think it's like true Asian, because I have a young Asian girl myself, and she specializes in more than just dentistry. She can work with people who had mouth defects or birth defects. I don't know how mm-hmm. I can put that. So she's studying a little further. These are last year students who are being graded by other doctors. So they do an excellent job, and we can get in there. I would just try it. You have to call because they have another session coming up, I believe, in March or something like that, February, March, but you have to call like now, and they'll have a recording on when they'll take more calls. So if you're interested in getting some work done or just in general, I'm kind of comparing to what my dentist said, what they said. It's a little bit different.
Yeah, I could imagine when it's students and somebody looking over their shoulder.
Right, because when I went, some of the stuff they said that was okay, it really the Marquette said no. And I told them that. They get a little offended sometimes when you tell them you went somewhere else. It's all they're all in training. I said, well, you were in training at one time yourself.
Well, they're all in training. They're practicing. They're always practicing.
Right, but I'm saying my regular dental office.
Yeah, your regular dentist office is a practicing physician, which means, like everybody, the more they do it, the better they get, but they're all practicing.
Right, yeah. Right, you're right. And there's a black dentist on 13 Drive. And, of course, we know a lady up on Appleton, but she's not taking any more patients. There's a black guy on King Drive. He was actually on the news on a special program mm-hmm. a few weeks ago, like on 24 or 18 or 36 or something like that. And I believe we have two or one more besides him. I believe there's another person. I'm not sure if she's in Appleton or what. But, yeah, so check out Marquette.
I will do that. Thank you much. I appreciate it.
Sure. You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Take care. 833-212-1017 is the number. That voice sounded familiar, but yeah. So I think I told the story. I went to the doctor the other day, and my doctor wasn't there. My medical doctor wasn't there, so they had a nurse practitioner there, right? But the nurse practitioner had a student nurse practitioner who came in and said, so is it okay if I work with you and come in and help you? And she started walking in the room, and I looked at her and I said, no. And she kind of paused like, well, what? No, I want to see the nurse practitioner who's licensed or a medical doctor, not a student. And she looked like she was going to cry. But then I said, okay, come on. And she just took the vitals and asked me questions, and she didn't do any real. I think she took my blood pressure, but I think she was nervous after that. So I was kind of like, this is kind of tight, you know, but she did a really good job because I knew she was learning and she was, you know, coming through like that. So I said, yeah, show her some love. And she did great. She did great. She asked me all the right questions, and then the doctor came in. But I did tell the doctor, I don't want to be double billed for this. She says, what do you mean? I said, I'm not paying for your student. You're getting one payment for this treatment. So you're not going to toss in a cheaper amount for the student and then another amount for you. No, that's not happening. So I'm going to be checking my insurance. Yes, that's just how it is. 833-212-1017 is the number. I'm never going to. So I said I was going to get to this, and it threw me for a loop, but I want to figure out what this is going to turn into. All right. In an unprecedented decision, this happened last night. Alabama's Supreme Court ruled frozen embryos are children. So critics say it could have a chilling effect on in vitro fertilization. So from CNN.com, it's the first of its kind ruling. Alabama Supreme Court said frozen embryos are children, and those who destroy them can be held liable for wrongful death, a decision that puts back into the national focus the question of when life begins, and one that reproductive rights advocates say could have a chilling effect on infertility treatments and the hundreds of Alabamians who seek them each year. And critics say the ruling could soon have consequences nationally as other states could attempt to define embryos as people. Already, one religious group is using the Alabama ruling as precedent in a Florida abortion rights case. So here's my, before all the legal advocacy and group justice and pregnancy this and American that get all into it. So what's an embryo? I think that's the first question that one should ask. So what exactly is an embryo? So an embryo is an unborn or unhatched offspring in the process of development, in particular a human offspring during the period from approximately the second to the eighth week after fertilization, after which it is usually termed a fetus. Now, if I remember, fetuses were like baby calves before they were born, and like we attach that to a human being, which I think is, I think it's ridiculous, but say no more. It's also called a rudimentary stage of that shows potential of development, right? So an embryo in an initial stage of development of a multicellular organism, and in organisms that reproduce sexually, embryonic development is part of the life cycle that begins just after fertilization of the female cell by the male sperm cell. So in a way, well, not in a way, life began. So if you kill an embryo in Alabama, or you say, we're destroying these, you can actually get in trouble. And you can actually, like, go to jail because the Alabama Supreme Court said embryos are children, their life. The ruling stems from two lawsuits filed by three sets of parents who underwent in vitro fertilization procedures to have babies and then opted to have the remaining embryos frozen. Parents allege in December 2020, a patient at the mobile hospital where the frozen embryos were being stored walked into the fertility clinic through an unsecured door, removed several embryos from the cryonic nursery. The state Supreme Court ruling said the patient's hand was freeze burned by the extremely low temperatures the embryos were stored in, and the patient dropped them on the floor, killing them. Parents sued for wrongful death, but a trial court dismissed it, finding cryopreserved in vitro embryos involved in this case did not match the definition of person or child. But in a stunning reversal, the state Supreme Court of Alabama disagreed, noting extrauterine children or unborn children located outside of a biological uterus at the time they're killed are children, and they're covered under the state's wrongful death of a minor law. So we'll see where this goes, but I don't know. 833-212-1017 is the number. Before we go to break, Al, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
I think that is one of the most ridiculous things I have ever heard of. But I have to understand that is Alabama, because they're always coming with some insane, outdated, prehistoric law. It makes you think that Alabama want to be stuck in a certain time where they wasn't even there. But my thing is,
Well, hang on. Explain yourself why you think that's arcane and outdated.
Well, how are you going to say something is an embryo when it takes a man and a woman?
No, it's both. Embryo is after the sperm enters the egg and it starts to create life. This is after that.
Right, but it's still, they saying if you get rid of it, I just think it's outdated.
Okay.
Because, you know, it was something a couple years ago when I was in school, and they had came up with a law that it was a felony if you get caught walking down the street with a vibrator in your back pocket. And we all said, who going to do that in Alabama? They're always coming with some outdated laws. But let me ask you a question. If you bring up anything about them ships down there at the end of that ocean floor down there, is they going to say they're human? I bet you they can come up with every excuse to say they're not.
Oh, they're already coming up with a reason why they made hundreds of millions of dollars off of the Clotilda, but yet when it comes time to pay people for what they did, they don't want to.
All right.
All right.
Have a good day.
Later. Yeah, it's kind of, you know, I kind of disagree with Al as it relates to that. They can be 6 to 8 weeks and then they freeze them and they can be used for a surrogate pregnancy, right? Surrogacy. So, you know, they just put them in the mother through a procedure and they're born eventually. So if it takes. So I kind of understand what Alabama's saying. I wouldn't say it's like, I don't understand the backwards part. Like, what's backwards about somebody believing? Like, you may not believe that life begins at conception, but you may believe that after 6 or 8 weeks, is that enough? I don't know. So we'll see. Time will tell. It'll work its way around. And once again, we'll be behind because, you know, we'll always argue it, you know, left versus right, liberal versus conservative, progressive versus unknown. Like, who knows? And then we'll fight about it. It'll go to the Supreme Court, depending on who's there. All I can say is interesting.
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 1017 The Truth, the Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Gruber Law Offices, and The Truth have raised the stakes for this year. The One Call, That's All Gruber Cash Giveaway is now a 5K giveaway. Yes, you heard it right. $5,000 giveaway. Every weekday on 1017 The Truth, you will have the chance to be entered to win the 5K giveaway. Listen to The Truth for the One Call, That's All cue to call for your chance to win $5,000. Gruber Law Offices, One Call, That's All. Visit 1017thetruth.com. For official contest rules.
When it comes to getting the smile of your dreams, you can't just trust anyone. So look no further than Bubon Orthodontics. Bubon Orthodontics is Wisconsin's number one Invisalign provider and has been providing the best value for braces and Invisalign since 1993. With 15 convenient locations, you're sure to find one in your area. Schedule your free consultation today. Call or text 262-522-7447 or visit BubonOrtho.com. Bubon Orthodontics, a family treating families.
Behind every minority and woman-owned business is a dream. Sometimes growing that dream takes extra funding. The Associated Bank Community Uplift Loan is here to turn your business dreams into reality. Apply online and get up to $50,000 in as little as one business day. With competitive rates and more accessible credit score requirements, we're making it easier than ever to fuel your company's growth. Let us uplift your business with the support it deserves. Visit associatedbank.com/uplift to learn more. Subject to credit approval, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Imagine, if you will, a wonderland of vehicles.
An entire convention center filled with things you love to drive.
It's the Milwaukee Auto Show at the Baird Center downtown, February 24th through March 3rd.
Immerse yourself
in the latest new cars and trucks. Fun things to do every day.
This year, come try your hand at the Golf Simulator.
It'll tell you how to improve your game.
Play a round of mini golf with the kids on tricky trails.
Or put on a VR headset and paint a car.
See website for dates and times of all features.
The Milwaukee Auto Show.
Save big on tickets. Go to autoshowmilwaukee.com.
I'm Shanola Hampton. Every day, millions of people face hunger. Today, I will share with you some of their experiences. I'm stuck between paying for medications or paying for food. John from Maine. After paying my bills, I can buy groceries. It's sad to say, food comes last. Alice from Oregon. I thought pantries were for less fortunate people. But anybody could be less fortunate in a day or even a second. Claire from Virginia. The Feeding America Network of Food Banks helps provide over 6 billion meals to people in need each year. No one should have to worry where their next meal will come from. Together, we can end hunger. Learn more at feedingamerica.org.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Tune in to the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. Black history always. That's tonight. Wait a minute. Watch this. It's the 20th. All right. All right, here we go. Here we go. The award-winning 101.7 The Truth is home to Milwaukee Panthers basketball this Friday night. The Panthers are at home as they host the Youngstown State Penguins. Coverage begins at 6:30, tip-off at 7. Truth Street Team will be in full effect Friday night, handing out swag. The Truth Street Team is sponsored by UW Credit Union. They're here for every you. And you also know that we celebrate Black excellence here on 101.7 The Truth and the most monumental moments in our history. So tune in all month. As we celebrate Black History, 101.7 The Truth Celebration of Black History Month is sponsored by Tayback Law, Educators Credit Union, Freightert, and the Medical College of Wisconsin, and American Family Insurance. 833-212-1017 is, I should probably check the talking text line to see what's going on. It depends on the country. So we were talking earlier. About whether or not what you would go to another country. Somebody said, it depends on the country. Would I go to Mexico, China, the Caribbean? No. Canada, Western Europe, Japan? Yes. And as with anything, you need to do your research. And then Wayne said, Dr. Ken, your conversation around embryos lacks some context. Some women simply have their eggs frozen, meaning they're unfertilized. In other situations, they're married couples that have multiple eggs fertilized, but the couple gets pregnant on the first try. This could result in unused fertilized. Well, what I said was that they were fertilized because they had, anyway. An attorney for the couples? Okay. So the case was based on the fact that the couple sued for wrongful death based on law. So it was an unsecured doorway, and there were embryos. And in order to be an embryo, you have to have been joined sperm with egg. Otherwise, you're not an embryo, if I understand it correctly. You're just an egg and a sperm. But together, it's an embryo. Do I have that right? Okay. And that's what they sued for, because they said that basically noting extra uterine children, unborn children located outside of a biological uterus at the time they are killed are children, and they are covered under the state's wrongful death of a minor act. That means the sperm joined with the egg created the embryo, which then grows into a child. Got it? Okay. So that was, I don't think it lacked any context because that's what I said. They weren't eggs. A fertilized egg is an embryo. So, like, it can't be an embryo unless it's fertilized. So, beginning of life cycle. All right. 833-212-1017 is the number. But that was a good question, Wayne. Good context. Very, very good question. Good way to go back and cause me to have to re-explain it. So this was a married couple. They did. The eggs were fertilized, and they were embryos. So fertilized eggs are called embryos. So, okay. 833-212-1017 is the number. Hey, y'all. Did y'all hear? Wisconsin high school students, and I'll be talking about this in my top five at five, ranked in the top 5% of their class are guaranteed a spot at UW-Madison. And if you're in the top 10%, you can go anywhere. So this is funny. You're so arrogant that you would say you're so arrogant that you would say 10%, you can go anywhere, but you can't go to, like, if you're top 6%, you got go somewhere else. Like, UW-Madison is that arrogant. You know what I'm saying? Wow. I find that amazing. That UW-Madison is that, like, yeah. They're like that. Yeah. Interesting. Let me try to squeeze this call in. Eddie, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
Hey, how you doing, Dr. Ken?
What up?
I wanted to ask you a question. Now, I know there's been a lot of arguments about pregnancy, if I recall, because some about abortions is a certain time limit on it. If you do it before 6 weeks, that's the safe zone, right?
No, I think the safe zone is 18 weeks.
18 weeks?
Yep.
So
that's okay, and like the state of Wisconsin said 20.
Oh, wow. So when, what are they saying life begins or whatever? Because even with the embryo, I'm trying to figure out when they freezing something that's developing, or are they just freezing an egg and a sperm? Is there a heartbeat in there anywhere?
There's no heartbeat in there anywhere, but they're freezing a fertilized egg, which is called an embryo, because now it can grow into a fetus and then a child. Does that make sense?
Yeah, but to me, life begins with some kind of heartbeat, right?
That's your
even
call.
Even with the 18 weeks.
That's when your heart.
The 18, your 20.
Heartbeat starts at 6 weeks.
I mean,
weeks.
Don't you got.
But the fact that you can feel pain, when you can feel pain, when there's significant movement and all that, is 18 weeks.
And I know this is going to sound stupid, but.
No?
No, what I'm getting ready to say may sound stupid. But, you know, they say there are no such things as stupid questions. But anyway, what I'm thinking of this here, one, I believe in order for something to be living, it has to have a heart or something in order to develop or whatever. So what's the difference between a chicken egg and they sit on it and it hatch a bird, but if somebody breaks it before the chicken develops, you know, you just got the egg and the yolk. So with the embryo and that state, how can they say charge you with murder when there's nothing? I don't even know if you can say it's a he or she in that stage, can you?
No, but an egg is unfertilized. We don't eat fertilized eggs.
But you get fertilized some kind of. Yeah, I know, but don't. I mean, the chicken has the egg and then they sit on it, and for some reason they go through a metamorphosis and turn into a chick, right?
If it's born, sure.
Right, but before it's born, it's just a yolk, and that's what I'm saying with an egg. There's no heart, no nothing there. So I don't, that's the part that confuses me, how they can say this person committed murder or whatever, wrongful death of something that is not to that stage of pain, feeling, heartbeat, growing. It's in a frozen state, so it's not developing, if I got that right.
Well, Alabama law disagrees with you. So, yeah. There you go.
Well, I guess I'll take a trip down there and ask you what's up.
Yeah, you might want to use right, the internet first. All right, take care, Eddie.
Oh, okay, yeah, that'll save me some money.
All right. It will. All right.
Yep. All right, thanks, Dr. Ken.
833-212-1017 is the number. I mean, but anyway, getting back to it. Top 5%. We were talking about before, top 5%, if you're in Wisconsin high school, you get to go to UW-Madison. They ain't paying for it. You just guaranteed a seat. Ooh, am I way over? Like, way over? Like, I heard you holler. Goodbye.
My name is Ariel. When I arrived in the U.S. at 19, I struggled to find job opportunities without my high school diploma. My entire life changed when I took a chance and got my high school diploma at age 22. Everything I have, my education, my career, my marriage, I owe to the Adult Literacy Center and my teachers. They were with me every step of the way, helping with my English and math, making sure I push through all the challenges.
Ariel, your success proves that what I'm doing as a teacher has real meaning.
It was an honor helping you achieve your greatness. Now you're helping others achieve theirs. It inspires me.
Education was the key that unlocked all my opportunities.
When you graduate, they graduate. Find free and supportive adult education centers near you at finishyourdiploma.org. Brought to you by Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
No young person should ever have to worry about having a safe place to sleep at night, or a warm meal to eat, or whether anyone cares about them.
But the reality is, 1 in 10 young adults will experience a form of homelessness this year.
But the good news is, there's an organization making a big difference. Covenant House.
For over 50 years, Covenant House has been helping youth in crisis and giving them the support and the tools they need to succeed in life.
I have no words to express how Covenant House changed my life. They just really genuinely just wanted to help me succeed, and I'm succeeding.
When youth who are experiencing homelessness have a hot meal, a safe place to sleep, and love, most of all love, they can overcome heartbreaking challenges, and their lives are transformed.
Covenant House is changing the lives of young people in cities across America.
To learn more, go to covenanthouse.org today. Thank you for caring.
We are the home of Milwaukee Black Talk. 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
Bringing you his authentic perspectives on important topics.
They live in suburbs together. They live in the city together. They hang out together, all in the same family. We're the only idiots that fight because we want our voice to only be on one side. Like, does that even make any sense? And when the side loses, you lose everything. They, on the other hand, have a voice no matter what, because somebody that looks like them is always in control.
Frank, candid, and straight to the point.
Well, it's just a skewed system.
Of course it is.
It's a lot of adjustment.
But answer my question, though. Should we let people go? Should we let people go? Like, let's just forget about bail altogether. And if your neighbor commits a homicide and kills people up. If you kill people and they next to you and you just let them come back and live right next to you, they can live upstairs from you. Let them come in your house.
Frank, candid and straight to the point. This is the best radio show in the state of Wisconsin. Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth and The Truth app.
Now, he's the mayor of the city of Milwaukee. He's a young man. Give him a chance. I only complain about things that I care about. What I want you to do is pretend like I'm in St. Louis. And all I'm asking the mayor and the Common Council president and the Common Council, show me.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee, here is Dr. Ken Harris.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris, 833-212-1017 is the number.
Number five.
Speaking of number five, there is a, and if I get a chance, I'm gonna play some audio to it. But get this. It's been 59 years since the assassination of Malcolm X, and the conspiracy surrounding his untimely death still weighs heavily on a culture missing one of its greatest leaders. Well, attorney Benjamin Crump is doing his part to continue the fight for truth and justice in the murder of Malcolm X. Nationally renowned civil rights and personal injury attorney hosted a news conference today, the same day Malcolm X was assassinated, to introduce two new witnesses who offered evidence in the alleged conspiracy case. It took place at the Malcolm X and Dr. Betty Shabazz Memorial and Educational Center in New York City. And according to the press release, this is all from news1.com, two elderly witnesses were security associates of Malcolm X, arrested a week before his assassination, and had never spoken before publicly. So it's interesting to recognize that they had an affidavit and recounted the events that led to the assassination. Hassan, known as at the time as Richard Melvin Jones, said he recalled that Malcolm X is delivering a speech. Someone yelled out, "N-word, get your hand out of my pocket," before a loud explosion caused disruption and led to gunshots ringing out. Hassan ran toward the stage and saw a man fleeing down the aisle with a gun. That person was Talmadge Hayer, also known as Rajahid Abdul Halim, who later admitted he took part in the murder. Hassan said he knocked down Hayer and continued to the stage to see that Malcolm X was near death. Hassan said he was overcome with anger and ran back to find Hayer, who was already outside being beaten by Malcolm X's followers. And to this day, despite my presence inside and outside of the Audubon that day, law enforcement never attempted to interview or obtain a statement from me regarding what I had seen, heard, and actually did that day. So I don't know if that's the same guy that they said did it or didn't do it, or did he admit? I remember there was a video on Netflix about the assassination and how some guy was tied up in it and that he admitted he had a part in it or something, and then he passed away. So I guess we'll never know, but now they've got two witnesses coming forward, and we'll see what that will hold in the coming weeks.
Number four.
When was the last time you've been to Red Lobster? I guess I got to ask that first. When was the last time you've been to Red Lobster? I haven't been to Red Lobster in let me be honest, about 15 years, maybe 20. So, this story from CNN Business, Red Lobster is in trouble. If you like Red Lobster, be careful. Its solution, all-you-can-eat lobster, just months after an endless shrimp promotion led to deep losses that the company's still trying to dig out of. In celebration of its annual Lobster Fest, Red Lobster is giving 150 winners an endless lobster experience, a two-hour complimentary feast of unlimited lobster with two sides and Cheddar Bay biscuits. Now, I got to say, biscuits at Red Lobster are absolutely phenomenal. I think they'll probably kill you over time because they got a lot of butter and a lot of... Anyway, Florida-based chain is hardly the first retailer to use these kind of stunts to get attention, but the endless lobster experience comes at a tumultuous time. Red Lobster reported, you ready? a record $12.5 million loss just in the fourth quarter of last year. In January, minority investor Thai Union Group announced its intent to exit Red Lobster, citing a $19 million loss for Red Lobster across the first 9 months of 2023. The COVID pandemic, high interest rates, rising costs, industry headwinds ultimately caused Red Lobster to have negative financial contributions to Thai Union and its shareholders, they said. On February 19th, a couple days ago, on an earnings call with analysts, Thai Union Group updated the $19 million figure and said that it generated $22 million in losses across the entirety of 2023, and they're promptly bowing out. So to fix it, they're going to give away more food, unlimited, for free. So I guess the calculation we really need to work with is how long will Red Lobster even be around?
Number three.
I don't know if you heard from TMJ4.com. Republican Eric Hovde is seeking to unseat Democrat Tammy Baldwin in Wisconsin race for the U.S. Senate. Republican businessman, real estate mogul Eric Hovde launched his bid for the U.S. Senate against Wisconsin Democrat incumbent Senator Tammy Baldwin yesterday, calling for bipartisan solutions to bolster the middle class and to tackle immigration and national security. Hovde said, "We have to stop putting on the red jersey or putting on the blue jersey and competing against one another. We need to put an end. We need to put on red, white, and blue jerseys as Americans and come together. Re-electing Baldwin to a third term is critical for Democratic hopes to maintain majority control of the U.S. Senate. Democrats are defending 23 seats in the Senate in November, including two held by independents who caucus with Democrats. That's compared to just 11 seats that Republicans hope to keep in their campaign. So it'll be an interesting race. We saw what happened yesterday with poor turnout, but I don't know. We'll get to that.
Number two.
Speaking of, the polls have closed. Guess what? In District 5 for Alderman, which includes part of the Northwest side, incumbent Alderman Lamont Westmoreland got 84% of the votes, beating out Bruce Winter and Stacey Smitter. Winter moves on to face Westmoreland on April 2nd when Smitter is eliminated. Here's what I don't understand. If you got a three-way race and somebody gets 84% of that, there's no reason to have another race. Like, there's no reason to take the top two. That's just me. District 7, which includes part of the North Side, DeAndre Jackson and Jessica Curry got the most votes and will advance to the spring election on April 2nd. The winner will replace current Alderman Khalif Rainey, who announced he'll not run for re-election. Challengers Randy Jones, Kenneth Hughes were promptly eliminated. District 11, Southwest Side, current County Supervisor Peter Bergelis got the most votes and will advance to the spring election to take on former State Representative Josh Zepnik on April 2nd. Lee Whiting is eliminated. And that brings us to
number one.
Well, you didn't hear it here first because what? Because with the primary victory secured, Mayor Cavalier Johnson looks to move ahead in the general election on April 2nd, where the two top vote getters will advance to compete for the city's mayoral seat. Well, Cavalier Johnson got 83% of the vote, David King 12, and Leisha Griffin got 4%. Looking ahead, the two top candidates from the primary will now prepare for the spring general election. Who you think's going to win? 83321. Okay. In a statement, Johnson expressed his gratitude and commitment to the city's future. Johnson shared a message to celebrate his win and looked at the general and looking forward to the general election. Tonight, as the results of the primary election come in, I am filled with immense gratitude. I want to extend my heartfelt thanks to each and every one of you who cast your vote, demonstrating your faith and confidence in our shared vision of Milwaukee. Still looking for the shared vision, Mr. Mayor. Haven't quite heard it yet. The mayor highlighted the progress made in enhancing safety, prosperity, and inclusivity but acknowledge that there's more work to do. Could you give me some examples of that, sir? While acknowledging the achievements, he stressed that the work is not done, pledging to address ongoing challenges and fulfill. I need details. Like, I love generalities, and it sounds really good, and it makes your heart warm, you know, but it really doesn't really tell me anything. He says, I'm honored to serve as your mayor, and even more to have your backing as we approach the general election. Can we get something done, like, in our community? That's the only thing I want. Can we get it cleaned up? Can we get it fixed up? Can we get it, you know, I'm just saying. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Come in with straight truth.
And the truth was, after November 3rd, after the election, poof, it was over. It was a political idea. I don't have to wait till it's said and done to realize we got played. I said it back then and I stood 10 toes on it. I said, this ain't no black movement. This something else. Just because it say Black Lives Matter, I started looking at the movement and what was going on, and I said, this is a political agenda.
Catch the Tory Lowe Show every weekday from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m.
Injured? Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
Literally one call, that's all.
I made one call, and that's all, worry-free.
One call, that's all. It worked.
Just one call and that's all.
They will do what they say they're going to do. One call and that's all.
One call, that's all means security.
It's literally one call, that's all.
It's a phrase we'll never forget.
Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Behind every minority and woman-owned business is a dream. Sometimes growing that dream takes extra funding. The Associated Bank Community Uplift Loan is here to turn your business dreams into reality. Apply online and get up to $50,000 in as little as one business day. With competitive rates and more accessible credit score requirements, we're making it easier than ever to fuel your company's growth. Let us uplift your business with the support it deserves. Visit associatedbank.com/uplift to learn more. Subject to credit approval, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
What's up, Truth Nation? It's Black History Month, and the award-winning 1017 The Truth is partnering with the Milwaukee Bucks for their HBCU night game on Tuesday, February 27th.
That's right, Mel. To celebrate Black excellence, our Truth family will be broadcasting live from the Pottawatomie Club at the Pfizer Forum from noon to 6 p.m.
Yup, and we'll be speaking with people from the Bucks organization, HBCU graduates, and members of the Divine Nine. So make sure you tune in as we celebrate HBCUs and broadcast live from the Pottawatomie Club at Pfizer Forum, Tuesday, February 27th.
Victor deployed for the first time to Afghanistan in 2003. At 4 in the morning, my phone rang. They said, I regret to inform you that your husband was wounded in action. Victor sustained a moderate traumatic brain injury. I was doing school full time, and I was also then caring for Victor. One of the most important elements of caregiving is taking care of yourself. I just didn't want to forget that I also had goals and that I also had a life. What I did is I challenged Victor to meet me halfway. There are almost 6 million military and veteran caregivers across the nation. We have our own journey, and we can fulfill that journey at the same time that we are helping our loved one.
Visit aarp.org/caregiving for a free military veteran's guide to navigate your caregiving journey and better care for your loved one and yourself. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. Black-owned business give back is back. We have teamed up again with Associated Bank to help local black businesses grow and succeed together. The home of Milwaukee Black Talk will be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to black business each quarter of 2024. So to sign up for this incredible marketing opportunity, Visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild community's backbone through exposure on the truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC. And remember, we're proud to be celebrating Black History Month with the Milwaukee Bucks. That's next week on the 27th for their HBCU game. Make sure you tune in to the award-winning 101.7 The Truth from noon till 6. Truth Family will be there. Potawatomi Club, Fiserv Forum. You'll hear Melanie Ricks, Tori Lowe, and me, Dr. Ken Harris, bringing you all your favorite content live from the Milwaukee Bucks HBCU Night Celebration Games. Tune in. Special remote broadcast live from Potawatomi Club, Fiserv Forum, noon to 6, Tuesday, February 27th, Milwaukee Black Talk. 833-212-1017 is the number. There's a story on CBS 58 where a quarter of smokers quit within a year or two of menthol bans. Researchers have found out. So we've been hearing that menthol cigarettes are like some of the worst things you could possibly do, right? Menthol cigarettes like will kick your hiney and make you addicted and all that stuff. So the U.S. Food and Drug Administration said that a menthol ban is a top priority, but public health advocates have accused the Biden administration of dragging its feet, and the ban has gotten caught up in a election year politics despite research showing clear health benefits. So the new research that was published in the Journal of Nicotine and Tobacco Research looks at studies that have examined the effects of bans in more than 170 U.S. localities, two states, several countries, and the European Union. Research did a deep search of English language studies on tobacco use that were published through November of 2022. The pooled results showed that about a quarter of menthol smokers quit within a year or two when the substance is banned from cigarettes. They found that the menthol smokers who didn't quit after bans were put into place, about half switched to non-menthol cigarettes. 12% switched to flavored tobacco products, and another quarter found a way to continue smoking menthols. National bans seemed to be most effective, the study showed. Menthol cigarette smoking rates were lower in settings with national bans and highest when there were only local and statewide bans. So if you haven't heard, one of the things that makes cigarettes even more highly addictive, and from what I understand, has killed people in communities of color, is menthol cigarettes. A 2020 study showed that 43% of all adult smokers smoked menthols. 83% of black smokers did. And so they found that menthol-flavored cigarettes are particularly appealing to children, studies show, so a ban could literally stop new smokers from ever starting. But what they found is more than half of kids who smoke choose menthol cigarettes, and studies have found that children who smoke menthols are more likely to become regular smokers than occasional smokers. They like the flavored smelling, the harsh taste, the smell that may put some new smokers off. But menthol also anesthetizes the throat, making it easier to deeply inhale the dangerous smoke. And so that's why people are trying to get rid of menthol. Once people try inhaling a regular cigarette, it literally drives them to not want to smoke. But yet, we haven't banned it. And so why don't we just do that locally? Why don't we do it locally? Blacks die at significantly higher rates than whites from smoking-related illness, including stroke, heart disease, and lung cancer. Black people make up 12% of the population and account for 41% of smoking-related premature deaths and 50% of life years lost associated with menthol tobacco products between 1980 and 2018. They figure if menthols were banned, this is a Council on Foreign Relations study, that if menthols were banned, the gap between black and white lung cancer would close within 5 years. But my question is, what can we do to actually get rid of lung cancer? It's to smoke or smoke very little. I think that's the only thing that we could actually do that would actually help that go away. And I think it's unfortunate because I've always heard that menthol was an issue. I'd always heard that smoking menthol is the thing that did in black women, black men, as it relates to smoking. So what are we going to do? Like, how are we going to get over this, right? 833-212-1017. Should we be banning menthol cigarettes? Just get rid of them. Just wipe them away. That's what I say. I say just get rid of them. Just come in and just wipe them out. Now, will that put people out of, you know, people will lose jobs. People will probably get laid off. But I think that's a little more important than lives being lost. But that's just me. What are your thoughts? 833-212-1017 is the number. Should we be stopping people against their own? But that's in line with the trying to tell people what kind of stove they can have, trying to tell people what kind of soda they can drink. I think if people decide to drink something and hurt themselves, that's on them. But that's just me. That's on them. If somebody decides, hey, I want to come in and I want to do this, I want to do that, then I say you should be able to do it. But, you know, that's just me. 833-212-1017 is the number. Sandra, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
Hi, Dr. Ken. It's me again.
Hi, Sandra. How are you again?
I'm sitting right here on this seat, and I'm doing okay, and I'm looking at my little doggy. Look me in the face and want me to get up and take him outside, all of this stuff.
Well, take him outside.
Yeah, you just don't know. My hands are tired.
So what's on your mind?
I do what I have to do.
Mm-hmm.
What I was going to say, okay, you were speaking of cigarettes, the menthol, all that. I never smoked. So my husband smoked, and he smokes the menthol. But anyways, I'm just thinking, now my son, he smokes, and my daughter said she started and she stopped. And then I took my sister, one of my sisters, years ago, she wanted to start smoking. And they had clinics set up at the malls. And I told her, I said, go up there and look at the lungs that the people have that smoke. After she saw the lungs, she never touched another cigarette. But I'm just seeing, I think I kind of seen where they could do x-rays or something to see if they, you know, starting to get that lung cancer.
Right.
And, I think everybody that smokes should get that test, just like the women get the pap smear and all that stuff. What's the other one, the breast cancer test?
Mm-hmm.
I think they should have a test mandatory for them. Because, number one, once they get the cancer, it's expensive. And then you got the, the health thing, insurance is too high and we can't afford it and all that stuff. So if you want to cut down on all this stuff, I think you can do preventative medicine for, you know, the people. I mean, if you care enough. I mean, I know it's a seller for them, but it's not good for the people. Because a lot of them, I'm sure they're short-winded.
But if they choose to smoke, and if they choose it, should we usurp their right to smoke and tell them that they should, that, you know, or just stop them from smoking? But then the flip side is many of these people don't have health care, and the public dole ends up paying for their health care because now they're sick.
Yeah. Well, I'm not saying, though, but get a test, mandatory test. Let them get a test like I get the breast cancer test all the time.
Right.
You know, get a test, and then you'll see if they got the start. If you can stop it in the beginning, it won't advance.
That's true. That is very true.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yeah. Well, thank you much, ma'am.
Okay.
All right.
Talk to you again.
Take care.
Okay, you too.
Bye-bye. 833-212-1017 is the number. Black Conscience, you're on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
The truth, the truth, the truth. The you truth. Can't handle the truth.
Okay.
What's up, Doc?
What up?
So, unfortunately, in this society, in this world that we live in, even though it's written, this should be a little bit more detail-oriented. Just when you tell people they shouldn't or what's good for them, they're going to do it anyway. Because we tell people having sex, unprotected sex, is bad for you, yet still we got that going on. Gun locks is good. But
is that a reason not to do it?
Lives been taken.
Is that a reason not
to do it? That is a different, well, it should be. If it's about your health, you're gambling with your health. And I'm glad you brought this subject up, because I stopped smoking 13 years ago. And the mind is a very powerful thing. I didn't use no tactics. I just witnessed my wife's brother die from cancer, and that just did it for me. I seen this man go from a healthy, living specimen, dwindle down to nothing, and that was it. And a lot of it comes, and it's just not menthol, the cigarette period. Nothing, the lungs is not made for chain smoking and things of like to be taken in, and there's no way of cleansing it. So we've just been told menthols, but, you know, it's a combination of a lot of other things with that.
That's true. That is true.
Because you people that never smoke menthols have the worst case of cancers from lung cancer, from smoking, whatever non-menthol brands that they were smoking. Our lungs is not, it's mainly only to filter the air and other things, but it's not meant to inhale smoke for years and years. On the small side, but on the larger side, you know, some of those chain smokers who just can't,
right,
who smoke a pack of, 2 packs a week and all of that.
You mean 2 packs a day?
Well, yeah.
You're trying to be nice, right?
Yeah. So these things is what causes us to have these issues. So, you know, we tell people don't drink and drive, yet still we have it. So you can scream it to the world, scream it to the heavens all day long, but it's still the decision they make, and that's their, you know, that's their choice, unfortunately.
All right. Well, thank you much. I appreciate it.
Live righteous, Milwaukee, and quit smoking.
Hey, does that include cigar smokers too?
More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com. It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 101.7 The Truth. Here is Tory Lowe with his truth.
This is a true story by Tory Lowe. A commotion unfolds as two women argue inside of a car. The situation escalates when one woman pleads with a bystander asking for help to remove another woman from her car. The bystander, confused and concerned, asks, "Who is this woman?" She explains that she took her to church but wants her out before something bad happens. An older man, apparently familiar with the situation, approaches and demands the young woman in the backseat to leave. He threatens to involve the police. The bystander asks the woman outside of the car what the woman in the backseat did. She mentions something involving a child. The bystander immediately knew it was serious. The older man heads into Walmart to call the police while the bystander calmly approaches the woman in the back seat. He offers her to take her home out of fear for the woman's safety. The woman agrees to leave the car, but chaos ensues when the woman who requested her removal starts acting even more erratically. The woman from the back seat starts screaming, prompting the bystander to act quickly. A passing male driver offers to take the woman home, and the bystander agrees. They recognize each other from past encounters, establishing a sense of trust. As the woman leaves with the Good Samaritan, the bystander wishes them well and exchanges sentiments with the Good Samaritan. The situation was resolved just as the police arrived. The bystander informs the police the issue has been resolved and bids them a blessed day.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 101.7 The Truth. Listen to The Tory Lowe Show weekdays from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m.
If you're a veteran, join the Soldiers to Civilian Self-Care Sunday, free bi-weekly group wellness session for the local veteran community. Every other Sunday at the Sherman Phoenix from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. Learn more at shermanphoenix.com or at 262-228-6021.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality.
The traffic and weather update on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by the City of Milwaukee's Direct Connect MKE. Make connections and explore career opportunities by visiting directconnectmke.com. Eastbound on 94, we are seeing backups from before 84th Street all the way through the stadium interchange to 35th. The westbound side is going to be slow from 25th Street all the way to Hawley Road. Southbound 43, you are seeing some backups heading right through the Marquette interchange over the high-rise bridge. You're also going to see continuing delays all the way down to the KK River. And then on 43 southbound at Locust, we've got a crash off on the right shoulder, so that's going to start to slow things down through there. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight. Mostly cloudy, slight chance for showers to the south later on with a low of 40. Then tomorrow, stray morning showers to the south, decreasing clouds, a high of 48 at the lake, 53 inland. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This is Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Give it up for Naughty by Nature!
Want to remind you the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is home of Milwaukee Panthers basketball. Don't miss any of the hoop action by listening to Panther basketball on 101.7 The Truth app, and all your favorite streaming platforms. Panthers are home Friday night as they are set to take on the Youngstown State Penguins. Coverage begins at 6:30, tip-off at 7, and we got all that fun stuff going on. 833-212-1017 is the number. Talking text line. I think Alabama law agrees with you. They might have to go to court to get the embryos destroyed. I believe after a certain time, embryos are not viable. From looking up, so I looked up whether or not that could happen, and my quick anecdotal research said that embryos that are frozen, if the temperature is correct, could conceivably last as long as they're frozen. They say on the outside it takes, you know, after 10 years, it's questionable. But I think they just tacked on 10 years and said it's questionable because, you know, they don't want to be responsible for actually, like, taking care of embryos for 10 years. But from the sound of it, as long as they stay frozen and at the proper temperature, they're viable. So, yeah. Anyway, can you explain the effects? This is from Stacy. Can you explain the effects of menthol from non-menthol? That's what I'm assuming. So the MD Anderson Cancer Center, which is Maryland, says the minty coolness of the menthol covers up the harshness of the cigarette, so smoking is easier to tolerate. Got it? But as a result, menthol smokers inhale more deeply and they smoke more cigarettes. That means that over their smoking lifetime, they take in more of toxic chemicals and tar from cigarettes. The other thing is menthol is highly addictive along with tobacco, so it's significantly harder to quit smoking menthol cigarettes than it is smoking regular cigarettes. But the issue is this. When is the federal government going to come through and just ban menthol? You want to ban 20-ounce sodas in New York. You want to ban stoves over perceived emissions because it uses gas instead of electric. Like, you want to come up with all these things, but you can never quite figure out a way to get rid of the things that actually matter. Like cigarette smoke, we already know. Not cigarette smoke, but, well, I guess it does. Cigarette smoking can cause cancer. But people want to make money, and we allow companies to make money, and we put things on the side of it so they can read it. Menthol is a whole different level that we can actually tell people, no, you can't make it. Just like liquor. You can make liquor if you want, but you can only make certain kinds. You can only make certain kinds. I tell you, sometimes life is just so interesting. So we read the story the other day that Tony Evers signed the maps into law, right? The Republicans supported what Tony Evers wanted in the congressional maps. They got chosen. The Supreme Court chose maps, and they were like, eh, that's a little much. So then they said, we're going to go with what Tony Evers drew up as maps, right? This is breaking news from JS Online. Wisconsin Democratic Governor Tony Evers is asking the Wisconsin Supreme Court to take up a motion to reconsider the state's congressional maps after Wisconsin's legislative boundaries were changed to weaken Republicans' grip on state legislature. What are you doing? This is what you asked for, right? Well, the story goes on to say that Evers asked the court to reconsider the congressional lines the same day he signed into law new maps that gave Democrats a chance at competing for control of both chambers of the state legislature for the first time in more than a decade. The high-powered Democratic law firm of Elias Law Group filed a motion with the high court last month asking the court to reconsider the congressional lines ahead of the 2024 election. The group argued new lines were warranted after the state Supreme Court, when considering the legislative map challenged late last week, said it would no longer favor maps that minimize changes to existing boundary laws, a theory known as least change approach. Given that the maps the governor submitted in Johnson were grounded in that last change approach, the governor urged the court to review. This doesn't make any sense. These are the maps that you made. Now you're going to court to change your own maps that you said you wanted. The governor urges the court to review its decision and stand ready to participate in any future proceedings the court may order. What? His request is his latest development in the congressional map inquiry as Democrats face a tight deadline to put new maps in place with under 9 months until the November election. The maps have to be in place by March 15th. You want it. You drew. Evers, later approved by the state Supreme Court. U.S. Supreme Court in March 2022 rejected the state's legislative maps, also drawn by Evers, but declined to block the congressional lines. Now, they argue that Evers' congressional map was drawn under the now-defunct least change constraint. Come on. Come on. So you want more? Is this, you want even more? So you were given what you want. You asked for it. You were given what you want. And now you want more. Interesting. Your thoughts, 833-212-1017 is the number. Where's all this going? Wayne said, MD Anderson is located in Houston, Texas. Okay. All right. Not Maryland. Houston, Texas. Okay. All right. Thank you. 833-212-1017 is the number. I'm confused. So you asked for, you drew a map, you got it, and now you don't like it because you drew a map, but you said it was the wrong map. So you sign something into law, and then you turn around and you complain that you signed something into law. Why did you sign it into law? You know what that sounds like to me? Double-mindedness.
Don't touch that dial. More of Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harrison is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. The Milwaukee Panthers take on a Horizon League rival in the Youngstown State Penguins Friday night at the UW-Milwaukee Panthers Arena.
Trailing Freeman for three, bullseye!
Scott Warris has the coverage Friday starting at 6:30 on 1017 The Truth and the Educators Credit Union Milwaukee Panthers Sports Network from Learfield.
Toss for Stewart. Three in the wind. Bullseye. 1.2. Stewart buries one. There's always room for Jello.
Tip-off happens at 7 o'clock.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program. We're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll. That's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We've already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Hi, this is Tanine Rucker, Program Manager at Safe and Sound, inviting you to join us for our six-week resident leadership training course beginning February the 21st, 2024. If you want to know how you can be an empowerment in your neighborhood, please join us for this six-week course. You can register at info@safesound.org. Again, that's info@safesound.org. Or on our Instagram page at Safe Sound Inc. Again, that's Safe Sound Inc. See you soon.
Life's better with American Family Insurance, because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The 2024 UNCF Milwaukee Mayor's Master Ball, taking place Saturday, March 2nd at the Hilton Milwaukee City Center, is one of Milwaukee's premier fundraising and social events of the year. Hosted by the Honorable Mayor Cavalier Johnson, this nonprofit gala is supported by corporations, civic leaders, and Greater Milwaukee. So get ready for an evening of celebration and support for UNCF. The annual Mass Ball is a formal black tie benefit with a seated dinner, silent auction, live entertainment, and so much more. For more information, please visit UNCFMKEMMB.com.
You are listening to Truth in the Afternoon with Dr. Ken Harris on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. Hey, want to remind you, Friday I'll be giving away my last prize pack and my last box of Concordia Red Elephant Chocolate. And we're going to be talking about the 2024 Black History Female Inventors Challenge. Like I said before, 1919 patent became the precursor for the what we now know as central HVAC system that we use in houses to keep them cool and keep them warm. That was Alice H. Parker. Sarah E. Good probably stayed married because she invented the fold-out bed, so when her husband started snoring, she could throw him out the room. Also, our third winner, DJ, won by coming up with the name Lyda D. Newman, who is the woman who revolutionized black hair care with a synthetic bristle brush. So we've got one more coming up on the 23rd. That's Friday. So make sure you hang around and do all that. 833-212-1017 is the number. Yep, we got one more Friday, and we'll have giveaway that last prize pack and chocolate, and then we'll go from there. All right? Pretty cool. Pretty cool, I think. Pretty darn cool. Pretty cool. Let me check the talking text line. Yeah. MD Anderson. Yeah, who was that? Wayne. Thank you for that, Wayne. I looked it up and, where is it? It's attached to the University of Texas. And so evidently they've got a robust cancer network down there. And that was just part of an article. I looked at it and when I Googled it, it just gave me the answer, but it just said MD. And I made the assumption, which was, of course, incorrect. And you know what happens when you make an assumption, when you assume you make a, anyway. 833-212-1017 is the number. I just find it interesting that we haven't gotten rid of menthol cigarettes. We haven't given them the boot. We haven't decided to say, you know what, we need to get rid of these. I don't know. So now we want to do congressional maps. We already did the state. Now we want to do congressional. So he's trying to make sure that Democrats are in power forever. My question is, what does that mean for black people? Because we ain't getting nothing now. And the last time Democrats were in power for the state assembly, the state senate, and the governor's office, we didn't get nothing in. We sure asked for it. And they came a-begging, but when it came for payback, we got nothing. And so, as usual, we're back to, you know, begging and complaining and saying, you know, we need the, yeah. But when it comes down to it, we're not going to get anything. We're not going to get anything. And I think that's unfortunate. And we don't seem to fight for anything either. We don't tell people what we want ahead of time. I say tell them what we want ahead of time, and if they don't come through, get rid of them. But we won't do that. So, anyway. So, if you've been anywhere near your phone over the past 48 hours, or at least 24 hours, the Wisconsin Amber Alert, they're missing two Rivers boys are missing. Let me do this. I love computers when they work, and boy, when they don't, it's a mess. This Amber Alert from Two Rivers, issued for a missing 3-year-old boy from Two Rivers, and search for has intensified. Authorities say Elijah Views, caregiver, last saw him at 8 a.m. at his home on Tuesday morning, 39th Michicot in Twin Rivers. He was last seen wearing gray sweatpants, a long sleeve shirt, dark colored shirt, and red and green dinosaur slip on shoes. So residents organized a search party this morning. And both Two Rivers police, along with state and federal crime scene response teams, have been present. And as more community members join the search, they're covering areas near Forest View Cemetery and Holy Cross Cemetery. Shannon Dax, a Two Rivers resident involved in the search, said, "A missing child like that going missing, especially in a small town like this, I can't imagine what that family is going through." Another person, a Maggie Remaker, said everybody's looking for him and yelling his name. She's involved in the searches also. So it's a little scary, and it's unfortunate. I hope they find the child. There have been several, if I remember correctly, Yeah, that's right. There's a number of missing people from the Milwaukee, Wisconsin area as well. I think we need to have sensitive crimes come in and work on getting them in to discuss exactly what's going on with all these missing folks. We've had a number of missing people pop up over the last few days. I think recently, about 35, 40 minutes ago, there's a 50-year-old Milwaukee man that's missing. So I think we need to step up and I mean, do we need to start putting chips in people? And do we need to start, I hate to say it, like connecting people to other people so that they don't drift away? I mean, you might have dementia, you know, Alzheimer's. That may be one thing. But we have cell phones. Keep a cell phone on. Track. Like, for instance, if you have a cell phone, do you let people track you? Shoot me a talk and text. Do you let people track you? 833-212-1017. Do you let people track you? Do you let? So here's the weird part. You'll let an app track you. Where you going? I see people. Hey, I'm waving. I landed in Miami. I'm like, you know, you live in Milwaukee and you just put on Facebook that you're in Miami. So if somebody knows where you live or can find out where you live, they're going to clean you out. Interesting. So I think they stop people. People have stopped doing that. But do you let people follow you? You let apps follow you every single day. Where you are, where you're going, what you're doing. You leave your Wi-Fi on so they can figure out where you are because your Wi-Fi hits other Wi-Fi it's not connected to. And you know, your household Wi-Fi has a static address assigned to it. So when you do that and you drive down the street, if your phone's Wi-Fi is on and it tries to connect to your Wi-Fi at your house, even though it doesn't, or if it doesn't, or your neighbor's, it can tell exactly where you are. It can triangulate within feet where you are. So you're not hiding from anybody, right? So I just find it interesting. I just find it interesting that we have an issue with someone following us, but we will allow apps to not only follow us, but take our information, sell it, and make a $1 trillion company out of it. Then we're okay. But I can't let Ray Ray, can't let Pookie follow me because, you know, can't let boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife follow me because, you know, you're invading my privacy, right? You're invading my privacy. I can't let you see it. It's bizarre. One of the most bizarre things I've seen. And we got to come up with a way that Facebook, IG, X, LinkedIn, all that. If they sell your information, they should pay you. There should be a way for the average citizen to have name, image, and likeness. Even if they're not playing a sport, they should have a right to sell it along with their information if they want to. You're listening to Truth in the Afternoon. I'm your host, Dr. Ken Harris. Tory Lowe Show is coming up next. I will see you in about 22 hours. Make sure you have a great time. Last time when I came in, it was 63 degrees. Lord only knows what the temperature is now, but hopefully it's nice. Even got my car washed today, so we'll see. God bless. Take care. Thank you, Rhea. And whatever that dude is, what's that dude's name? What's his name again? What's his name? Ray Ray? Pookie? Okay. We'll see you in 22 hours. I'm out.